There's lots of exciting stuff coming out with React 18, and in this lesson, we will look at how you can get set up with TypeScript so you can start playing around with it. So let's go. Now, I'm assuming that you probably have some React TypeScript application set up. If you don't, we're going to create a fresh one over here with npx create react app, my app, --- template TypeScript. Once we have the application, we're just going to cd into it and open it up within our IDE. Now, if you look at the package.json, you can see that it currently has React 17 for React as well as React DOM. We update this to React 18, which is currently in alpha by npm installing React from the next tag by specifying @next. We do the same for React DOM, and then we're going to use --force as we don't want to resolve any pair dependencies. Now, if this was untyped JavaScript, we could start using React 18 at this point. The key enabler for the new features within React 18 is this new API called react-dom.createRoot. It takes a DOM element and creates a container that can then be used to render any React component. Here we're just going to replace react-dom.render with root.render, and we don't need to provide the element anymore as that is already attached to root. Beyond enabling modern React 18 features, a key advantage of this API is that you can call root.render again and again with different components, and you don't need to get a reference to the DOM element again and again. Now you can see over here that we are getting a red squiggly under the createRoot API call, and the reason for that is that TypeScript does not know about the presence of this function yet as it is new to React 18. Fortunately, the type definitions have already caught on, and you don't actually need to install anything else, they are already shipped as a part of @type/react and @type/react-dom. Similar to the naming convention of installing the next version of React by running npm I react @next, the type definitions for the next version of React are actually contained within files called next within these particular type definitions. So if we open up tsconfig.json, we can include them by adding a types section within our compiler options and specifying that we want to include react/next as well as react-dom/next. And that's it. Now we can start using React 18 APIs within our application. However, you can see that we still have one error within our index.tsx, and that is because TypeScript is a bit more particular than pure JavaScript, and it's complaining over here that createRoot expects a DOM element to be passed in. However, with getElementById, there is no guarantee that the root element is actually going to be present. In our case, we know that the HTML that is going to get served is going to have this element, so we can use the TypeScript null assertion operator, which is !, to specify that null is not something that is going to be returned in this particular case, and we are always going to get a document element, which we can then use to create our root. And that's it. You can run npm start to verify that you successfully updated your React 17 application to React 18. If you enjoyed this lesson, then smash that like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.